Hi, now let's discuss about cell culture technology. Cell culture is the growth of our cells, animal cells, and or human cells outside of the body and of an intact organism in a cell culture to produce biologically materials such as many more cells or cell-related products such as proteins, DNA, or viruses. Our biotechnological industry is based on cell culture. So this is an important and of practical aspect I want to discuss with you today. So we'll cover cell culture and equipment and reagents and so-called cell lines and primary cells. So what is cell culture? Is the process to grow and maintain cells under very carefully controlled environment outside of the living body. So cell culture is usually related to in vitro experiment. So in vitro makes experiments possible that would otherwise be difficult or impossible in intact organisms. For example, multiple assays in parallel with the same number of cells is very hard to perform in vivo or intact animals. And so by using this in vitro technique, there's a little bit of advantages such as we can perform experiments faster and less expensive than using actual animals. And we can perform much well controlled to draw conclusions. So goal of in vitro experiment is to generate hypothesis and conjecture about what occurs in vivo, which is the most important in the end. So what is hypothesis? Hypothesis is a worldview that is testable. So you can generate hypothesis, which is easier with in vitro experiment, and that clue can be bring into in vivo and hopefully maybe a human or clinical practice. So this in vitro experiment require careful experimental design and also proper interpretation. So we have to keep in mind that during this in vitro experiment, we have to ask ourselves that does a cell in a culture flask dish truly behave like it would do inside in the living body? And many times in vitro experiments, we use a cell line, which is an immortalized cell types, which is you can grow almost indefinitely in the petri dish. So are these good models for cells that are present in a real body? This is a very important question. So let me give you an example. So a cancer cell line, such as HeLa cell, is originated from it's ovarian cancer or cervical cancer from decades ago from one single patient, and that cell becomes transformed into growth in a plastic petri dish and it's immortalized. So we perform many experiments, for example testing a new drug, anti-cancer drug, with this cell line. However, we have to know that this cell line only comes from one single patient, while out there are millions of many patients whose cancer, even if it's the same, let's say cervical cancer, then may behave not exactly the same. So we have to know the limitation of when we are using a cell line.